Okay, so you've cut a cuff. Your cuff, if you've not got an opening on it, needs to be big enough that when it's joined with a seam that you'll be able to fit it through an average hand to get it on and off. So I've just measured that, and then the desired depth of the cuff, because that's the design decision, and then added the seam allowances all the way around. I've creased it just so you can show that's obviously that it's double, so it's double the amount. That's the hem, the finished edge at the bottom, the cuffs like inside and outside. So the first thing you need to do once you've made your sleeve is make your cuff a tube. You don't want seams showing, so you don't want to sew it this way and then sew it down, because then you'll have nasty seams showing right on that edge. So I want it all bagged out and contained. So we have the two short edges, which is effectively the inside seam, and you put right sides together and sew that short edge with whatever seam allowances you've added. Normal stitch length. And then obviously you would take it to the machine and under press it. So then you'd put it through a sleeve ironing board, press the seams open and give it a nice under press. And then I'll just show you what will happen is that will fold up. So you've got that nice finish cuff. Check that you can get it on and off your hands quite tight. So that's for a small wrist. So just check, because this hasn't got an opening on it. Obviously some cuffs will have openings on that are different. So you need that one sort of tighter so it will sit on the wrist. Now on your sleeve, it's what I'm doing here, the bishop sleeve, so it's gathered. You just need to then mark the opposite. So I've got one seam on my sleeve, which will be the inside. So I need to mark the opposite halfway point, just so you're gonna put those gathers in and distribute them equally. So I'm just gonna divide that into four. It's quite important when you're doing gathering or pleating if you want an even look. Obviously, if you want it uneven, then you don't do it. You don't distribute it evenly, but that's the look I want. And I'm then gonna just pull these up initially, my gathering. You can run two rows of thread and just pull those along just to gather the threads approximately. Okay, and then obviously it's a design decision how much you've actually gathered it up by, as opposed to how that cuff's going to fit. So this I'm going to sew in open. I'm not going to do it double, because then we can bag all the raw edges into it. So again, I want to section that into four so I know my pins go in. It is quite a narrow cuff. So divide that with the seam halfway and then in quarters. You can use notches. So this should probably be marked on your pattern and have those as notches. That's an pattern marking that you can apply. And I'm just going to put think right sides together. So the cuff, it's got the inside seam and my sleeve is inside out. So I'm going to put insides, right sides together. So where they're sewn, that'd be right sides together. And I'll match the two seams. But I'm only sewing one edge of the cuff to the sleeve. I'm going to bag it out, all will come clear at the end. And then just my rough pinning. I know where my quarter marks are, so I can then match those pins together and then continue the gathering up. It was just roughly. Initially, take your time doing this, don't rush it. Match them up, because you can see like that was a bit that flat, but this isn't evenly distributed, so you don't want like really tight gathers. You want it all nice all the way round. So then just get hold of your gathering threads. It's better if you run two, it helps. And just make sure that then when you sew it will be flat on the cuff but the sleeve. And make sure that these raw edges, you see how that's got folded under, make sure they haven't curled underneath. So those, it's the raw edges that match on the top, because otherwise you'll end up with raw edges tucked and you don't want that. And you can see that I'm pinning horizontally, I just find that easier. And then that one actually just needs to slide across and distribute it, making sure that they are all tucked out, not caught up, so I don't have them visible from the right side. And again, that one needs to just be distributed a bit better, pulled up a bit more. And you can just keep sliding that fabric over and make sure then it's pulled flat. So the cuff is flat, but only a single layer, and making sure that the sleeve edges are all out, and pin them together. Take your time making sure that it's not bunched up, it's all nice and equal. Repeating myself now. Okay, and the last bit there. So when I sew small cuffs, the sleeve arm isn't always, it's sometimes too big for the cuff to go over, so that's okay. I tend to do it this way, so I'm just then going to wrap it around the foot itself, so it's quite useful. And I'm just going to use a 1 centimetre seam allowance. Obviously, you've got whatever you've put on your pattern. And if you're sewing this way where it's flat on the top, make sure that this is laying flat when you're sewing it. And you don't want any puckering on the cuff. You just want the gathering to be on the sleeve. And again, just make sure it's all nicely laying nicely underneath, so keep checking it as you go, trying to avoid sewing over pins. And obviously if you're not gathering it, you're pleating it or something, you just take your time to pleat it onto the cuff, whatever method you're using. It's just showing you how to bag the cuff out, because I want all nice and neat finishes for your garments, for high quality. Always aim high, don't want cheap manufacturing. This is quite a fray fabric. I haven't bothered seam neatening these because they're all going to be contained within the cuff, so I don't need to, but obviously I have seam neatened the edges that are going to show, and you need to make sure you do that before you attach the cuff, because once you've sewn over it, you can't then go back again. Make sure all your pins, trim all your threads off, and any frayed edges, pin those off. Remove those pins. So then what I've got when I pull it out is my cuff attached, and that's the inside of the garment. So I'll pull it round so you can see it on the outside. So you can see that's all nicely gathered on to the cuff. And then this will fold up, all right? So that will all be nice on the outside. Now we can neaten it on the inside. We have got obviously two ways of doing it. You could have just sewn that all together, the cuff folded, and then just overlocked that. But then you've got a nasty edge. It's not such a pretty finish. So we can tuck these raw edges, can all be caught down. So you'll have to take this to the iron and press that seam allowance, that 1 centimetre seam allowance down, and then you'll be able to fold that up and then potentially do a stitch in the ditch to hold that in place. Okay, so we've pressed it and we've made it nice and neat on this side, and then we're taking our time. We're going to arrange it so that this edge, and what you don't want is any twisting, all right, because if you pin it and then you get this twist on the cuff, you don't want any twisting. So you really want to make sure you know where the hold it taut, so you know exactly where each section needs to be. And then I'm going to pin it so it's just past the stitch line, because I'm going to pin it from the right side and it's going to be a stitch in the ditch. So take your time at this point. When you do those pins, pin it exactly the stitch in the ditch, and then check the other side and make sure that you've caught it, and you've also caught the seam allowance, because there's no point doing a stitch in the ditch if you're not doing the seam allowance. I've seen a bit of hemming where we haven't actually caught the raw edge. Okay, you've got to remember stitching on the edge, what you're doing, what the purpose and function of it is. So you want to make sure that that's it. You might find it easier to pin it the right way round because this is a very small cuff. Just whatever works best for you. If you're pinning it this way round, there's a lot of feeling, dexterity involved, making sure again that you're going to catch it and cover those seams. So I think it's easier to pin it inside out myself, and I think it's easier to sew it inside out as well, because I'll put it around, so all those seams are caught in the cuff, and then I'll put it around the foot, and it will be, obviously you'll have matching threads, and it'll be stitching the ditch, and then you're making sure that you catch it. Obviously you'll go all the way round, and that when you stitch in the ditch, you're right on that edge in that seam, and you're pulling it apart. Right, and then you're making sure that these are all caught inside the cuff. Take your time to pin it all. I haven't pinned it. Right, and then no twisting on the cuff. So I'm going to take my time to do this, but I'll just show you that small section. Right, so you can see that small section I've managed. And then you just, then it's all caught, and that won't be seen when it's on the same colour thread, but I'll get it all stitched all the way around. Thank you. Right, so you can see I've sewn that on up. Okay, so then that, obviously when it's stitched in the ditch, it'll be in the same matching thread. So you won't be able to see that from the outside. And then on the inside of the garment, it'll all be caught. And then all the raw edges are all on the inside. You take a bit more care, making sure it all matches. No birds nesting going on. Okay, but that is your cuff gathered onto your cuff, sleeve gathered onto your cuff, and then it's all nicely bagged out.